Organic food, is it worth paying more to feed it to your kids? Well, when it comes to meat and produce, the answer is probably yes, say pediatricians. But when it comes to milk, surprisingly, maybe not. Andrea Peterson is joining us right now. She is in New Orleans, where the American Academy of Pediatrics is meeting. Hi there, Andrea.
Hi, Wendy.
So you're right there on the ground floor where this news is sort of coming out from a study that this group did. Tell us about the nuts and bolts of what the research shows.
It's really interesting. Basically, what happened is the American Academy of Pediatrics, it's the first time they've weighed in on the sometimes controversial topic of the relative healthfulness of organic food. And what they found is they didn't go do new research. They basically parsed through all of the existing science that's already out there. And the bottom line is that for children, organic produce and milk might be worth the hefty price tag, but you could probably skip the organic milk. And you know, what they did is there was actually a big study of much publicized about a month ago that said that organic food is not typically more nutritious than conventionally grown food. The pediatricians pretty much are on the same page on that. There's some evidence that organic produce has more vitamin C and phosphorus, but in general, it doesn't seem to be any more healthy. But the thing is, children, they are unusually sensitive to the effects of pesticides. And the pediatrician cited numerous studies linking pesticide exposure to everything from memory problems and cancer in adult farm workers and an increased risk of ADHD in children. And they noted one pretty interesting study that showed that switching to organic produce for just 5 days actually dramatically reduced the level of pesticide residue in the urine of children who normally ate conventional produce.
Very interesting, Andrea. So let's just to recap for people again, they're finding that it's probably worth it when it comes to produce and meat, not necessarily with milk. Now let's talk about teenage girls. They were looking at some evidence about teenage girls and some of these hormones, pesticides, and then later in life, how that might affect them being at risk for breast cancer?
That's right. When it comes to meat, the first thing that pediatricians say that the risk of exposure to antibiotics from eating conventional meat, that is something that's significant. So eating organic meat could reduce the risk of disease related to antibiotic-resistant bacteria. There also seems to be strong evidence that there's teenage girls who eat more red meat from animals treated with hormones do have a greater risk of breast cancer later in life. Though there's also a concern about other hormones given to meat, and they said that they really need more. There needs to be more studies done looking at if a low level of estrogen does have some health impact. But for me as a parent, the organic milk recommendation was pretty surprising.
That is surprising.
A lot of us parents buy organic milk because we're concerned about things like growth hormones and estrogen often given to conventionally raised cows. But pediatrician said that growth hormone given to cows doesn't affect humans, and that when they've looked at milk from estrogen-treated cows compared to organic milk, there doesn't seem to be actually much of a difference in the amount of estrogen that's actually in the milk.
And very quickly, Andrea, are they still recommending, though, that whether or not it's organic or not, are they still recommending that kids get sort of a balanced diet with fruits and vegetables no matter what?
I mean, they're really emphasizing the fact that what they don't want these recommendations to do is have parents bypass the produce aisle altogether if they don't want to spend, the $6 for the half pint of organic blueberries. They want kids need a diet with fruits and vegetables. And there are cases where organic produce may be a little bit better, but get your kids to eat fruits and vegetables. That's sort of the bottom line.
All right, Andrea, thanks so much. Some interesting and surprising findings there. Thanks for bringing them to us.